Never do the baby, Bubba. We're here with original James Brown band member, Parliament Funkadelic, Bootsy's Rubber Band. Oh man, it's my pleasure. It's Bootsy Collins.
The name is Bootsy, baby.
Oh yes,
what's up, my man?
I gotta learn how to talk like that now, baby.
I see you got your fun glasses on, so you can see what you're doing.
Oh man, I had to put them on, man. They're not quite as funky as yours.
Oh yeah, but the crop is laid.
Oh shut up. Tell them the truth, man.
Yeah.
Now Bootsy, you've been playing for years and years. How many years you been in the music business?
Let's see. Ever since I think started around 1966.
Is that right?
Yeah, and about 68, 69, we hooked up with JB.
That so, quick, that's in a couple of years.
Yeah, yeah.
Your talent must have been just incredibly natural.
Well, we was pretty wild at that particular time,
okay.
And pretty aggressive, you know.
Uh-huh.
You couldn't be faking the funk around that because there was so many people that was like bad, you know, with so many musicians, you know, around that area in the Midwest, in the Cincinnati area,
uh-huh.
Dayton. I mean, it was so many bad musicians, you know, you had to go get them.
What did you have that was so special that JB picked you up?
I think it was persistence, the attitude.
Uh-huh.
You just had to go get it, you know, and you couldn't wait around, you know, like people would be waiting around watching TV and sending tapes and doing it. We couldn't do that. You know, that wasn't what crime it was. You know, you had to be there face to face with that mouth.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? And you had to rap and give it up.
There it
know?
Is.
And where was that? You had to go get it.
Okay. You know? And I think that's good advice for musicians out there, because so many people are sitting in the basement, just said nothing.
No,
you got to go out there and go get it.
Don't depend on the mail. You know, that's what all he's doing is going up, you know?
That's right.
And ain't nothing happening.
Tell me about when you first met James Brown.
That was pretty wild. It was like, if you can imagine Christmas multiplied by maybe 100 times, you know what I'm saying, when you're about 6 or 7 years old. So it was like, you know, it was pretty wild.
Okay.
It was pretty wild. And I don't know, you know, everybody wanted to meet James, and I never dreamed of meeting him.
Uh-huh.
Matter of fact, less known playing with him.
Oh,
you know?
Man.
So it was like, they was recording in Cincinnati, and they had a studio there.
Uh-huh.
So that's pretty much probably why I had the chance to really get hooked up.
Okay.
Because we just lived over there. You know, they wouldn't let us in or nothing because, you know, we was kids and,
uh-huh.
you know, fooling around. They wouldn't let us in, but we hung around. And, like, they call us the pest squad.
Is that
they had to send out for the pest control, you know.
But
it didn't mean nothing. We came right back, you know. Raid wasn't working.
I hear you.
You know
I hear
saying?
You. I hear you.
Yeah.
You guys, the raid wouldn't stop y'all.
Yeah.
I hear you. That was happening. What was, at that time, now James Brown was putting out hit after hit after hit, man,
yeah,
at that time.
Yeah.
And if I'm not wrong, the first song that you played on JB was Lick and Stick.
Lick and Stick was the first one. The first hit was, I mean, the serious
uh-huh.
was The Sex Machine.
Okay.
That's the first album we did.
Oh, man, I feel like I want to get and be a sex machine right now.
Hey, man, hey.
Move and do it, you know. Man, talking about sex machine, you kind of got like a, man, you know, I'm the best looking man in comedy. And you and Bootsy, will you tell me I'm the best looking man in comedy?
Oh, most definitely.
Oh,
by
shut
far,
up.
I
want to say, oh, man. But this outfit that you got on, what is now? You got red, white, and blue on this side.
Yeah.
What's the meaning behind that?
Well, it's a mixture of, it's just like saying that music is going to be the one to bring all the countries and things together. Music is the only thing that can do that.
Is that right?
Oh, yeah, because, it's between the humor and it's between the music thing, you know, because everybody else got that serious thing happening
uh-huh.
and the political thing, and that's, you know, mugs only go for that so much, you know.
Right.
Music is the one to make you dance.
It's the universal language.
Know?
And talking about the universal language.
Yeah.
Parliament Funkadelic had a universal language.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah, but see, everybody's ears wasn't open to, they had virgin ears.
Uh-huh.
You know what I'm saying? And now it's like the P was only designed for the serious funk.
Okay.
You know, and at a particular time we was coming through, it was a lot of virgin ears going around.
Okay.
And wasn't nobody hearing it. Funk was a bad word.
Uh-huh.
You know, so we kind of, George Clinton and myself kind of made that word legal.
Okay.
You know, so that's pretty much where we played our part at, you know, and then, and once the street people start picking up on the thing, and, you know, this was even before we had records.
Uh-huh.
You know, they were, like, talking about the funk, talking
uh-huh.
about the funk. And the people were coming to the concert. We were selling our concert. We didn't even have no records on the daggone radio.
Is that right?
Oh, yeah, they were scared to say funk.
Uh-huh.
You know, so, and that was all we was about.
Was the
you
funk.
Know? And, you know, we got this crowd happening, and then that evolved over into the record thing.
Okay.
And then when the record thing started happening, I mean, the people kept coming to concerts, selling out, and that's what started selling the records, and the radio started picking it up. They started playing, then we started selling out.
Man, that's beautiful.
You know?
How did you meet George?
Matter of fact, a friend of mine that's here, Malia Franklin.
Oh, the queen.
Yeah.
Oh, man, you know the queen.
Yeah, the queen. Uh-huh. Undisputed queen.
Yes.
Yeah, she's the one that really hooked me up with him because she's seen us at a club in Detroit.
Okay.
Called, dang, I forget the name, Soul Expression in Detroit. And they was like live. I mean, it was serious. You know, uh-huh. They had about two or three bands, maybe about three or four bands playing in the night, you know.
Uh-huh.
And we used to come through and just sit in, you know, and we just wiped everybody out.
Is that right?
You know, and it was about the look because we had been over in England with James and checked out the hot pants. They had the chains. They had the nets. I mean, we brought this stuff back to town with us.
Okay.
And we started wearing this stuff, you know.
So it was a whole new look,
a whole new fresh look.
Okay.
And it was wiping people out. We weren't playing no top 40.
Okay.
You know, we was playing all original stuff. And people seen it was like, you know, these mugs got that. I mean, they got all this nerve. They got to be about something. You know what I'm saying? So, and when she seen us, it was like, you know, y'all should meet, you know, George Clinton.
Okay.
You know, and hook up with Funkadelic, you
okay.
know. Because I guess that was the only thing at that time that we could even, I mean, that she could even see us relating to, you
okay.
know. And she took me over to his house, and it was like love at first bite, you know
oh,
what I'm saying?
Oh, man, that's beautiful. That's beautiful.
Yeah.
When you guys played with Parliament Funkadelic, what was your favorite cut with Parliament Funkadelic?
Let's see. Favorite one? Oh, man, that's a hard one. I think Swing Down, Sweet Chariot, I think.
Swing Down, yeah. Sweet Chariot. Can yeah. you do a little bit of that?
Oh, man, you got it. You know, you remember you asked me what was my video, and uh-huh. I couldn't think of it. Well, I mean, you know, we've been through so many trips, you know, it's kind of hard to remember.
I hear we ain't going to push it, man.
Yeah.
Speaking of your video, come to next, we're going to play your video, man.
Okay, do you remember the name of it?
Oh, man, it's
because I don't.
It's the Jungle Mates.
Okay.
Let's check it out. We'll be right back.
Be,
oh, man, oh.
Ha 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 ha.